While Americans counting on emergency coronavirus aid from Washington may have to wait until the fall, hopes for a swift compromise are dwindling as the White House and congressional leaders remain far apart on details. Capitol Hill correspondent Erik Rosales reports. Eric?
Well, Tracy, Republicans and Democrats, they're not even in the same zip code, much less the same state when it comes to COVID virus relief bill. Now, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi did hold a presser today, and it's been days, she says, that she's had a face-to-face meeting with Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin. I did press her and asked her, is Treasury Secretary Mnuchin correct when he criticized Democrats for not being willing to come to the table?
He also said Democrats have no interest in negotiating. Your reaction?
Now, you know what? I think something was wrong with his statement. We said $2 trillion, and then we can sit down at the table. Then he said, that's not what she said. She said $2 trillion, or we can't sit down at the table. Didn't you think that that was strange?
But the key may be in this phrase from Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin's statement, which specified, quote, she made clear that she was unwilling to meet to continue negotiations unless we agree in advance to her proposal, costing at least $2 trillion. I asked the speaker,
when's your next conversation with him?
I don't know. When they come in with $2 trillion.
And defending Democrats' call for money for the U.S. Postal Service to process mail-in ballots, the speaker criticized President Trump's concerns.
Now, the president is making a big distinction between nothing wrong with absentee ballots. I just don't like vote by mail. So I said to my folks, don't call it vote by mail anymore. Just call it absentee ballot. They're exactly the same thing.
On voting by mail, Illinois Congressman Rodney Davis warns,
I'm glad that the Illinois state legislature decided to mail applications for mail-in ballots, applications for absentee ballots, rather than mailing live ballots to registered voters like some other states do. That is a process when you mail live ballots that is ripe for fraud.
And on the Senate floor, the GOP leader calls for a deal.
Republicans have been at the table for weeks. We just need seriousness on the other side.
Right now, lawmakers are on call. They will be given 24-hour notice to leave their state and come back to Washington, D.C. and vote. Meanwhile, schools hoping for federal dollars to deal with this COVID virus relief, well, they're just going to have to wait, along with Americans across the country who are dealing with this pandemic. Tracy?
Correspondent Erik Rosales reporting from Capitol Hill tonight. Thank you so much, Erik.